गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट फ्रैक्शनल डिस्टिलेशन। दिस इज वन मोर मेथड फॉर द सेपरेशन ऑफ मिक्सचर, बट फ्रैक्शनल डिस्टिलेशन इज यूज्ड टू सेपरेट ओनली लिक्विड मिक्सचर्स। अंडरस्टैंड, फ्रैक्शनल डिस्टिलेशन इज अ प्रोसेस व्हिच इज यूज्ड टू सेपरेट लिक्विड मिक्सचर्स। अंडरस्टैंड, एंड दोज सपोज देयर आर टू लिक्विड व्हिच आर मिक्स्ड, एंड How will they get separate? They will get separate if their boiling point differs at least by 20 degree Celsius. If their boiling point difference of the boiling point between the two liquid will be 20 degree Celsius. Suppose here in a receiver we will have alcohol and water. Understand the mixture of alcohol and water. We all know that alcohol and water both are liquid in nature. Understand, the temperature of alcohol is 78 degrees Celsius, that is its boiling point. The boiling point of alcohol is 78 degrees Celsius and that of water is 100 degrees Celsius. We all know that water boiling point is 100 degrees Celsius and alcohol boiling point is 78 degrees Celsius. So we are seeing that both the liquid are mixing here. Understand, and what happens, both the liquid are mixed and both the liquid's boiling point is differ at least by 20 degrees Celsius. So this is the process of separating, two liquids. Understand, whose boiling point is differ by at least 20 degree Celsius. So see, I have drawn the whole setup. Now let me explain you first the setup. See here, this is a tripod stand. Beneath the tripod stand we have a Bunsen burner. Understand, this is a iron stand, understand, which is used to hold the apparatus. Understand. So what happens, above the Bunsen burner we will have china dish which is containing sandbath. Sandbath means balu. Understand why we use sandbath beneath the receiver? Because sandbath always have very high capacity to store heat. Balu बहुत देर तक गर्म क्या है, अपने अंदर रख सकता है, ठीक है, इसीलिए यहाँ पे यूज किया जाता है. अंडरस्टैंड, नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस, दिस रिसीवर इज कंटेनिंग एल्कोहल एंड वाटर. अंडरस्टैंड, दैट इज टू लिक्विड इट इज कंटेनिंग. अंडरस्टैंड, एंड अबव दिस लिक्विड व्हाट हैपेंस, अ फ्रैक्शनेटिंग कॉलम इज यूज. दिस इज अ फ्रैक्शनेटिंग कॉलम. अंडरस्टैंड लाइक दिस. अंडरस्टैंड, इट इज ड्रॉन देयर इन योर डायग्राम. Understand, this is a fractionating column, and the top of the fractionating column, what we are seeing? We are seeing that a pipe is passing through the fractionating column. Understand, and that pipe is enclosed with the Liebig condenser. Understand, and what happens at the mouth of the pipe, what happens, there a container is attached by the receiver which will help the liquid to drop one by one and collect in the receiver. Understand, this is a receiver, this is another stand. Understand, now see how, first let me tell you how this Liebig condenser, what is the work of Liebig condenser. I have explained it in my previous video also. Now here again I am telling you, Liebig condenser is used to cool the vapor of the liquid. That means when water becomes vapor, when it will store large amount of heat, what happens, water turns to a vapor. So this vapor, when comes to this pipe, what happens, because of Liebig condenser, it will help that vapor to convert into water droplets, and again this water droplets will be collected in the receiver. Understand, so Liebig condenser work is to cool the vapor to turn it into water droplet. How does it work? Here is water inlet you are seeing. Here is water inlet. From here, water will come. And from where it will flow like this. Like this, it will flow. Understand? Here only. Then, here. Understand? Here. Like this, it will cover the whole DB condenser and water will out from here. Here it will in, here it will go out. Understand? This is the Liebig condenser. Understand? This is the Liebig condenser. Now see how this whole apparatus work. Understand? So we are no. Before explaining, let me tell you one thing. The liquid whose boiling point is less. The liquid whose boiling point is less is considered as the less volatile. The liquid whose boiling point is less, is considered as less volatile. Understand? Considered as less volatile. And liquid whose boiling point is more, is considered as more volatile. Sorry. The liquid whose boiling point is less. Understand? The liquid whose boiling point is less is considered as more volatile. Understand? The liquid whose boiling point is less. Suppose what happens in alcohol and water, the boiling point of alcohol is less. So alcohol is more volatile. Understand? More volatile. जिसका boiling point कम होता है वो liquid क्या है? More volatile होता है. जिसका boiling point ज्यादा होता है वो less volatile होता है. So now see here. What happens when we will light up the Bunsen burner? What happens? A mixture of alcohol and water will get heated up. Understand? It will start heating. And what happens? Because of heat, what happens? The mixture start converting it into the vapor. Understand? The mixture start converting it into the vapor. And what happens? First, the less volatile liquid will rise up. Understand? First, the less volatile liquid will rises up, and what happens? Because of that, here we are seeing that a thermometer is attached. Understand? And until the less volatile liquid, when it will get heated up, and because of vapor, what happens? It will comes to the fractional column. Till that time, there is no rise in temperature. And suddenly we will see that it will again falls down and temperature starts rising. Now what happens? The more volatile liquid will cross the whole fractional column and it will pass through this tube. Understand? More volatile liquid will pass through this tube. Understand? And it will slowly and slowly passes through the Liebig condenser. And when it will passes through Liebig condenser, what happens? It will get cooled. And it will collected here in the receiver. Understand? By this process we will separate alcohol and liquid from the mixture. And what happens? The liquid which is less volatile, which is rise first, what happens? It will again come back to the receiver. Understand? It will again come back to the receiver. So what happens? Again I am telling you, when we will heat from the Bunsen burner, what happens? Because of heat, what happens? This alcohol and water will start converting them into the vapor. But we know that the temperature of water is more and alcohol is less. So what happens? Because of that, the less volatile liquid will rise first. Understand? And it will more volatile liquid will rise first and it will come here till the time it will passes through this and it will collected here in the liquid. More volatile liquid will be collected here. And the less volatile liquid, what happens? It will remain here in the fractionating column and again come back to the receiver. Understand? When less volatile liquid will rise, first less volatile liquid will rise. Understand? When it will rise, what happens? Till that time, there is no rise in temperature we will see in thermometer. Understand? This is thermometer. There is no rise in temperature we will see. But what happens? As soon as less volatile liquid work will complete, that means whole less volatile liquid will collected here in the fractional column, what happens? Suddenly we will see the temperature will start rising in the thermometer, and at that time what we will see, that more volatile liquid also coming to the fractional column, and it will passes through the pipe, and what happens, because of Rebic condenser it will cool and water droplet will collected, sorry, water, that more volatile liquid droplet will collected here in the receiver. Understand, this is the process of separating two liquid by the process of fractional distillation. Understand, this is a process used to separate two liquids whose boiling point differ by 20 degree Celsius. Suppose alcohol and water. Understand, alcohol boiling point is 78 degree Celsius and water we know that 100 degree Celsius. Understand? So this is the whole setup. Understand? This is the whole setup. So I have explained fractional distillation. Understand, I have explained fractional distillation. Now it is, I think, very much clear to you all. Now we will study about sublimation. Understand? Sublimation. Sublimation is a process you all have learned. What is this process? The process by which solid directly converted to its vapor. Understand, there is no conversion in liquid. What happens? Solid first convert to liquid, and from liquid it will convert to vapor. But the process by which solid directly convert to vapor, understand, is known as sublimation. Understand, that you all have studied in physics also, in class 6 and also in class 7 also you have studied. So what is sublimation? Sublimation is a process by which solid directly converted to a liquid. Understand? So see here, this is a Pre-Pod stand. This is a Pre-Pod stand. Okay, now what we will see? We will see that a conical funnel will place here. Understand? A conical funnel. This is the mouth of conical funnel. And what happens? Here some ingredients are placed. Here some ingredients are placed like this. Understand? What happens now here? Cotton is placed. This is the cotton. Understand? This is the cotton. What is this? This is the cotton. Cotton means rui. Rui se mung ko kya kar diya gaya? Dhak diya gaya. Understand? Now what happens? This is a mixture of ammonium chloride and sand. Yes, this is a mixture of ammonium chloride and sand. This is a mixture of ammonium chloride and sand. What is this? This is a conical funnel. This is a funnel. Understand? What is this? We all know that this is China dish. This is a China dish. This is a cotton. Tripod stand. This is Bunsen burner. Bunsen burner. Understand? So this is the process. Whole setup to do sublimation process. Understand? So what is sublimation? Sublimation is a process by which we separate solid. That means by which solid is directly converted to a vapor form. Understand? So now what we have seen? We have seen a China dish in which a ammonium chloride and a sand mixture is placed. In a China dish, a mixture of ammonium chloride and sand is placed. And what happens? That mixture is now, above that mixture we will have a conical funnel placed over it. Understand? Above that mixture we will have a conical funnel placed over it. And what happens? Its mouth is tightened with cotton. Its mouth is tightened with cotton. Understand? Now what we will see? When we will light here with the Bunsen burner. When we will light here with the Bunsen burner, we will see that what happens because of heat. Because of heat, what happens? Ammonium chloride, as it is a sublime. Understand? What happens? Ammonium chloride, it is in a solid state, and what happens? As soon as it will gain heat, what happens? It will convert to a vapor and settle here in the funnel. Settle here in the tube of funnel. Understand? It will settle here. Understand? What happens? It will settle here. Why? Because cotton is placed over it, and because of that vapor cannot go out. It will remain in the funnel. So it will settle here. Whole ammonium chloride will settle here and sand will remain here. We do know that there is no change in sand. Sand will remain its own place. But ammonium chloride, as it is a sublime, what happens? It will, after gaining heat, as it is in the solid state first, it will not melt. It will not melt. What happens? It will directly convert to a vapor form. It will directly convert to a vapor form and get settled over the mouth of the funnel. Understand? We will place the cotton above the mouth too, so that it will not go out of the mouth of the funnel. It will remain here. Understand? It will stick in the pipes of the funnel. Understand? So by this process, what we will see? We will see that ammonium chloride is separated by the sand. By this process, ammonium chloride is separated by the sand. Why? Sand will remain here and ammonium chloride will stick here in the mouth of the funnel. Understand? It will stick here. So this process is known as sublimation, and by this process what happens? We can separate ammonium chloride by sand. Understand? So I have explained two methods today. Understand? Many methods we have covered till time. Now it is better for you all to keep on studying and study each and every method. Study the whole chapter first, then study the process methods of separation. Understand? I have made several videos for you all only. Watch it, subscribe it, understand? So that you will get the notification to you whenever I will upload my video. Understand? And learn from it. Thank you.